We had Bob Kerman on a sunset launch, a resupply mission to the Kerbin Orbital Station. It's got a full crew, so they're chugging through their snacks real fast, and Bob is bringing up some more, keeping those guys in tip-top shape. Got our 4-meter cargo bay with some life support packs and some toolboxes. Well, get this thing up into orbit and then rendezvous with the station and dock. Right now it's just the ascent phase. Going up at a pretty steep angle to about 10,000 meters and then level off and skim the atmosphere to pick up orbital's velocity before we switch over to rocket engine cycle and so I'm developing some kind of weird balance issue here. Good thing I've got TAC fuel balancer. Took care of that. About to level off. Pick up some speed. Keep our ascent rate at about 5 to 10 meters per second. Start coming back up when we get enough speed for the wings to generate enough lift. Starting to get some shock heating here. We'll probably be able to take this up to about 20 kilometers before we have to switch over. Hopefully we'll have a good deal of speed by then. Our ascent speed here. We want to stay in the atmosphere for as long as we can to use the much more efficient turbojets to pick up speed. Ideally, we'll have more than 1500 meters per second orbital speed before we switch over to starting to get a little squirrely here. Keep this thing under control. Anyway, ideally, we'll have about 1500 meters per second orbital speed before we switch over to the rocket engines. It's a delicate balance here, keeping the altitude at a point where the atmosphere is thin enough to allow us to pick up more speed, but also thick enough to feed the engines. Should be able to get to about 20 kilometers without the engines being damaged from overheating. So view from inside the cockpit. This is a simple mission, so no need for a co-pilot. Once those two tanks are empty, we'll drop those before we continue our ascent into orbit. Right now it's only consuming the liquid fuel. Watching my ascent speed there, keeping it around 5 to 10. Watching the engine status. We're slightly off the eastward heading, so it's going to put us in a slightly inclined orbit, but should be easy enough to fix once we get out of the atmosphere. Should have plenty of delta V to make all the necessary adjustments and rendezvous maneuvers, and once we dock with the station, we can refuel for the trip back to KSC. Air starting to become too thin to feed the engines. You can hear it. The power is dropping. I'll let it go a little bit more. Before switching over to rocket mode. Once we stop picking up speed, now we we pitch up, and now we just want to get out of the atmosphere as quickly as possible and push our apoapsis up to orbital altitude. Struggling a little bit here. There we go. Get it back under control. Check our Delta V status. Go. Now we get our fuel tanks sorted out. We can drop those two empty tanks. Now we just coast and circularize. And then adjust our orbit to rendezvous with the station. Push up to a let's see where we time to match our velocity here. Not too shabby. Get rid of our maneuver node and just let's see where can we can dock. Let's get our docking port open. Controlling from the docking port, so the orientation looks a little bit strange on the nav ball. Now we just make our way over, nice and easy. find our want to move up above the station so we can get at the now would be pretty much impossible to try to orient the station at this point. We're just trying to get our prograde marker to match up with the our velocity prograde marker to match up with the target prograde marker. That way we know we are traveling towards it and not traveling in some oblique direction. It's rather slow. I'm gonna push the RCS a little bit more and hopefully it'll give us enough. There we go. Now we can find our target. There's our docking assistant. Need to move up slightly. Makes it a little bit difficult that the docking port is actually on the other side, sort of. Now I'm a little wary of docking on those docking ports because sometimes the SAS don't play nice and it can throw the whole station out of orbit. The docking station on the end of the fuel tanks are a much safer bet. We just have to get ourselves oriented. Shave off our speed a little bit here. Really care much about the roll here, but we do need to line up the big orange marker and the little yellow marker and the two green lines all at the center. This craft is a bit heavy and unwieldy, so take a little bit of time to get things aligned. How's our... Okay, we still have plenty of mono left. A little bit past now. Okay. Pretty close on one axis. But we need to get closer on the other one. Oops, a little bit too much. Is our docking port open? Yes, it is. At this rate, it'll be nighttime before we get docked. Okay, making good progress here. So coming in at about 1/10 of a meter per second. Now we just have to let it get close enough to let the magnetic force do the rest of the work. There we go. Come on. Excellent. We are docked. Let's make sure we're not drifting somewhere unintended. Excellent. Now we can open our cargo bay and get to work. Transferring out the supplies. And there's plenty of work to be done.